Okay, hi, this is Param. In this video, we will see, of course, there are many ways, right? There are many ways to ingest the data, right? So we can use any beads straight away, ingest the data into the Elasticsearch, or it can go through Logstash if you need more processing. That is one way, okay? That is one way. And another way is Logstash plugins, okay? You can do many manipulation on the event, then for that you can write a Logstash pipelines, then push into Elasticsearch. That is another way. The third way is ingest pipeline itself. So ingest pipelines are running in the server itself, sorry, Elasticsearch cluster itself, okay. So that is what ingest pipelines, okay. What else can be? Yes, there is an Elastic agent comes with the fleet server. Okay, fleet and fleet server, and of course you can have programmatic client. Okay, I'll leave it. So we are not going to discuss that one. So out of these three, okay, out of these, so I'm not comparing anything about right now Elastic agent. Okay, so there are a lot of articles are there. Okay, I think I have clubbed here also. Maybe I can share that. Crack processor. Okay, program client Logstash speeds. Functional bits, no. Okay, I collected gone through many articles also, okay, and I will show you at least at the end of the video, okay. So many articles discuss about the difference of these three. Of course, there is a difference is there among these three, okay. So it can be a capability, first thing. Second thing is it can be a preference. Third thing may be a comfortability. Okay, comfortability is okay. That is what. That also can play the role. Okay, so I will say. Okay, so here there are individual item comparison. In fact, okay, the green colors means we have a pipe. So that column is best one when compared with other stuff. Okay. Okay, so if it is yellow means it's kind of not exactly, but it's okay. So some of the points I have collected here, but still there can be many things are there. Okay, okay. So let's go with one by one. So the interest of this video, what is one? So which one you have to prefer among these three when you want to ingest the data? Okay, fine. Let's say if you have many output. So let's come on the first one of it. Okay. Okay, if you want that buffer, let's say the output in our case Elasticsearch, okay, the output Elasticsearch, that can be anything, right? So that DB or any Kafka, something like that, because of Logstash support many plugin, right? So here also processor, here you can see in the beats also we will see as a processor, in Logstash we will say filter plugin, in ingest pipelines we will say as a processor. So these are individual working unit. Okay, fine. Now, buffer is available. Okay, so that is one biggest advantage with the Logstash. Let's say if your destination is not available for some times, but at the same time you don't want to lose, or you don't want to reprocess your events, then, and you don't want to lose any event also, okay, then sometimes at least 5 minutes, 2 minutes, there can be buffer is there. Buffer may be a file based or size memory based. When buffer based wise, Logstash is our best one, okay. So there is nothing to stop. Then Logstash support many output. Okay, Logstash usually we will push it to Elasticsearch most of our project, in my case at least. But it support a lot of output plugins. Okay, you can see, check the Logstash output. There are a lot of plugins are there. So that means using the plugins, you can send your processor message or processor event to many outputs. Okay, in that aspect also Logstash is best one. Because of ingest pipeline support only one. Similarly, this also support beat also can be support either either file beat or Logstash or Elasticsearch. Only these two, right? So only these two it can support. But ingest pipeline can be output to the Elasticsearch only. Now the other things. Easy to start work with Kibana UI. Yes, Kibana UI has very awesome UI. Okay, yes, there you can declare, of course, within the stack management, there is ingest pipelines. There you can create your ingest pipeline. You can drag and drop, I mean, it's not drag and drop. if you want to change the order only you can do drag and drop, but you can easily work with the, you can easily add the processor and its parameters one after another, and you can do testing as well as, okay, individually you can give the documents and you can do testing as well there itself in the Kibana UHR, I'm saying. Okay, that is the easiest way. The other easiest way, what is, even if you have any REST client, I am using, most of the time I am using this, what is it, Postman. Okay, here I can evaluate, let me go open, simulate, simple. Okay, so here you can see that this is the, this is my simple, just a REST call. Okay, so here I can add my processor. Okay, here I can add my processor, and at the end I can add my message. Here you can see the message. Okay, so to test, this is very easy to test with any RESTful client. Say for example, the Postman as well. So in that aspect also, it's very easy to test. Otherwise, what you have to do? I have to write logstash pipeline. Okay, AML file, then I have to start my logstash, okay, it has to run a separate process, right? And if I want to do, if I have any changes, then again it has to start. Of course, there is also, is there, okay, there is also possible you can give that events, okay, I cannot say, but at the same time it's close, yeah, at the same time it's really very fast, okay. Here you can see that, let's say, let me go my logstash pipeline, okay. So here debug something, okay, here also we can have generator and two another test here at the end. This is very straightforward, but still we have to run logstash in our local. This is a minimum, okay. So I can have generator to generate the events, and I can have the filter plugins, and I can output here itself. So at least here I have to run logstash locally or remotely, anyway, in somewhere logstash has to be run, so that is my responsibility. But here, not when compared with that, no need. Okay, so it's a really quick to start. No, there is no, nothing. Okay, no one can beat. Of course, it has enrichment as well, efficiently. Okay, if what is my enrichment? I have explained in another video. In earlier videos, I have explained enrichment perspective. It's really good. How we can bring all the certic data into the Elasticsearch. Okay, so enrichment can be done very quickly. If you want to enrich, you can do the same enrichment in the logstash also as well, but that is, it's very tough. Yeah, at least it will introduce the network traffic, okay, from a logstash to particular your data source. So it has to go and query, then response has to come, then you have to apply. Okay, so when compared with the enrichment, ingest pipeline is best. Of course, it's have enough performance, enough. I mean, all the use cases can be achieved here, accomplished here. Okay, then of course there we have the last syntax wise, what is now here is YAML file, right? Okay, so here either we have to use YAML file again. You know, YAML file means it has to check as a config file. Sorry, it's a very big mistake. Conf and Ruby language. Okay, so you have to make sure the alignment, and you have to use the arrow, and you have to be familiar with the Ruby language as well for some times. Okay, of course we are not going to do that much, but still that is learning curve. Okay, if you are familiar with your Ruby language, you can do parsing effectively. Yes, you can do effectively. Okay, so that there is no doubt on that. If you are good in a Ruby language, then you are because of most of the logstash stuff written in the Ruby language itself. Okay, so that's why. So when compared with here, it's very straightforward. Just JSON and the painless syntax, right? I'll show here. Okay, see my Harry, where is my Postman? Postman here. See here, I'm just using JSON syntax. Okay, it's very neat. Even I would say it's a very neat. I can add most of the configured parameters are there in each processor. Okay, it's very easy for me, in fact, and list of the processor. Okay, so it's very neat. There is no doubt on that. Okay, so as a developer perspective, it's really good. Ingest pipeline processor, and Developer productivity is really more. Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. Because of it's a, because of it, I can't develop using Postman client like Postman itself, or I can't develop within the CRUD processor available in that dev tool, or I can try all this stuff in the dev tool itself, or I can try everything within the Kibana itself. Okay. So obviously, productivity is very fast, very easy. Okay. Reusability. Yes. Reusability here is very, I don't think any reusability, but I don't know exactly if pipe to pipeline communication is there, pipeline to pipeline integration is there, okay, but I think even that also can be passed from one to another, I think, I don't know, but the reusability here, okay, so this here is different, okay, so what is now, so each unit of task we can define as separate processor or separate pipeline, okay, we can in the master pipeline we can integrate. So that one pipeline may be reused by many master pipeline, right? So that is the reusability, is very awesome, very, very awesome. So reusability, if you want to reusability a particular logic, then ingestion pipeline is better, ingestion is best, okay, no one can beat here, okay. And for complex processing, we have to depend on Ruby filter, but it's an increase, okay, here, okay. For complex logic, right? If you have complex logic, so here we have this painless script, so we can use stored script as well, okay, or inline script. And the language stuff is painless, okay. That is more important one, okay. Painless script is really easy. It's kind of working with JavaScript, latest JavaScript, in fact, I would say, okay. So so for the, if you have complex logic, complex parsing, I would say it's really ingestion pipeline is far better. Because of the scripting support, but here we have to depend on Ruby language, so it's a kind of course again a new learning curve. Okay, at the timestamp field added. Okay, so yeah, this is minimal. Okay, but it's minimal only. I cannot say it's a very, very big one. Okay, it's a minimal only. So what is now the timestamp appended by the log structure, right? At the end, let's say and the particular event released from the log slash server, okay, to reach and ingest it to that server, maybe it may take 10 seconds or 20 seconds, right? Okay, definitely there will be delay. Okay, so if you want to 20 seconds, definitely this is 2 seconds or 1 second or something 20 nanosecond, maybe difference is there, definitely. But here, what is the no? So, whatever the time in the server, it's straight away it is ingested. So, ingested times is very more accurate, yeah. Ingested time is more accurate when compared with log slash. Okay, so because of that timestamp come from the ingest pipeline, so it will be more accurate when compared with the log slash, in fact, or log slash or this one file bit. Okay, events are not usable, then dropping them at yes here. Okay, this is what dropping ratio. Okay, if you want, let's say in one of his case, I will get 200 plus events. Okay, but every times almost 70% or 80% of event I will be dropped. Okay, so in that case log slash is better, that's why I put here. Okay, event are not usable, then dropping them at the log slash level are avoided to graphics. Okay, so what is now, yeah, that's what. So dropping rate, if you are dropping here in log slash itself, it will not use any network traffic, right? Again, you are saving your money. Money saving is perfectly same. Either log slash server is going to incur the money, or ingest pipeline going to incur the money. But at least network traffic will be reduced, right? Okay. So if you want to exclude some events, okay, I mean most majority of percentage of events are excluded, means are dropped, means log slash is better option. So at least to save your network traffic. Okay. So in that way, it's okay. So what is now? So whenever you have events, but most of the times you will ingest all of the event, mean that then we can go for ingest pipeline, the reverse ways. For every integrations, okay, most at least 90% of events are simply dropped, then log slash is better to avoid the network. Okay, if it is log slash running in the same target server, right? Let's say if it is targets, events are running the target server, then that's really good. Otherwise, it's waste. Okay, otherwise it's really waste one. Say source your target server somewhere and log slash server somewhere. Let's say this is region 1, this is region 2, and log slash is region 3. Then here is unnecessary, right? there is no point to discussing about the network traffic amount of bytes transferred. So already source event has to push to Elasticsearch. Instead of that, it is going to tightly push into the Elasticsearch. So in that case, la ingest pipeline is better. Okay. Provided Elasticsearch and targets source server. Okay, event source process are running in same server. Otherwise, it is waste. Okay, so that's why, as I said, like Elasticsearch is running region 2, source is region 1, like Elasticsearch is region 3. Then in this case, it is unnecessary. Okay, so yeah. If it is all are in the same server, then we can consider the Elasticsearch. Okay. Why? I don't want to hold the bold. Okay. Then you support environment lookups. Okay. But yeah, if you want lookups, okay, the lookup wise, it's really this one is better. Ingest is better. Okay, so whatever you want to, whatever you have, static data, we call it static data, reference data, or lookup data, right? Push all those data into different index in your Elasticsearch cluster, then do for lookup. Then that is easiest to be, okay. But you can do the similar lookup in the Elasticsearch as well, okay. But it will include that network traffic, network data, latency, everything's included. Okay. But it support. Elasticsearch support many lookups, many type of lookups. Okay. It support many inputs. Yes, as I said, input can be many things, sir. Input can be anything. So as number of plugins. Okay. So number of plugins are our input category. So it support many inputs, but it support only the ingesting documents. Okay, it support only the JSON document. In fact, I would say even JSON document. So support only JSON documents. Okay, then if the rate of traffic event are more large support tools. Okay, so I think that's what I have explained here. So again, I have pushed here. Okay, so duplicate. Okay. XML, yes boss, I cannot do XML parsing in the ingestive pipelines. If my event source is as a XML content, then obviously I must go with the pipeline. There is no alternatives. Okay. So these are the high level difference among these three. Okay. Of course, there is one more thing called, what is that? Elastic agent. Okay. So I have not learned anything about that. Okay. So I compared with these three. I compared only few criteria, okay, but there are a lot of articles are there. You can check in the net itself. Okay, there you can find all the articles which talks about which one is best, what are the benefit, okay, with the different beats or different ways. Of course, it's everything's based on your interest. Sorry, you not your interest, your use case perspectives. Okay, that is what I can say. Let me search where I have placed how to ship with Elasticsearch. No, somewhere I have all the articles, but I exactly forgot where I have pushed it. This is ML blocks, okay. Data frame, it's common. No, Elastic plugins, no, okay. It must be here, but I don't know whether I have not kept here. Okay, I think that's all. Okay, so thanks for watching. If you like the content, like my videos, leave your comments, okay, and subscribe my channel, share with your friends. Thank you.